So that's what we've done. These are the listings of the training programs. We run anywhere from 12 to 22 people each training program. We have now trained 223 Canadians and about, or 223 altogether, about 10 Americans. As I say, people come from Portland, Seattle for the training when it's held in Victoria. And we've trained one Japanese woman who served in Pomperetta. So the first Friday night, it's a weekend training session. First Friday night, we get together with everyone who's going to come to the training, and we serve them a dinner as true hospitaleros with tapas, paella, tarta de Santiago. And this is the point we ask them to leave their pilgrimage behind so that the next day they're ready to learn about being the hospitalero. I'm not going to talk about too much of the training, but this is at the end. Tom designed this scarf, which is, it's great for wearing around the albergue because you can be identified right away as the hospitalero. I don't know whether, I'm sure some of you walk into an albergue and you think, oh, are all these people? Because once you pack that song, everybody looks the same. So this is at the conferral on a Sunday afternoon as we wish everyone well. This photograph was taken of the training in London, Ontario in 2012, and this is Victoria, British Columbia, 2012. This is one of our hospitaleros from Victoria serving in France. And this is a hospitalero from Burlington, Ontario, near Toronto, serving in El Burgo de Reñero. And two of the things that are discussed, the new things that we discussed, because we change the program every now and again, with what we think works, what we think doesn't, what feedback we get from the people that we train, plus the feedback that we get from Spain, but what perhaps we should be incorporating. But two of the things that we felt are very, very important. How many have served as a hospitalero? Okay. We call it one exercise, shaking out the mat. And that's taking care of yourself. As you know, when you get on an airplane, and they give you the full drill of putting on your seatbelt, when the oxygen comes down, put the oxygen on yourself first before you help your child. That's what you do as a hospitalero. You have to take care of yourself first, or you're not going to be able to take care of anybody else. So if you've had a day where someone has cried on your shoulder, you've given all your emotion to someone, they're going to walk off the next morning feeling terrific. You have to take care of yourself and be ready for the next people. So this is kind of an important thing to get across to people that we're training. Because they're there for 15 days, take care of yourself. And not in a selfish way, but so you can get back. The other thing that we tell them to do, or that we try and train them to do, is see all these people sitting around the table. You know, there's going to be probably three of them that you're going to spend time with day after day after day. The others are going to go. No matter how obnoxious, or how tired, or how tearful a pilgrim arrives, they're going to leave the next day. So the people you have to get along with for 15 days are the other hospitaleros. And how do you make that a great experience for yourself? Something that often we don't think about when we walk out the door of our home, fly to Spain or France, and serve. So these are key elements to make the experience good for the hospitaleros and good for the pilgrims. And this is, have any of you bumped into these Amigos del Camino? It's a Spanish group. They wear yellow scarves, and they walk along the Camino picking up garbage. They're visiting our hospitaleros in El Burgo de Reñero. So we have had 150 of the 223 that we've trained have returned to the Camino to serve. Some people, of course, when they come back from the Camino, they're so excited that they hear there's hostelero training. And so some people sign up for it with all good intentions, but really what they want is another Camino kit. So we found that some serve, some don't, but they all have a wonderful experience. Places that our Canadians like to serve are places like Salamanca, Pamplona, Reunion, Santo Domingo de la Quesada, Zamora, Bracianos, Villa Casada Sierra, and of course, once they've received the training, they don't need to serve in the albergues that are run by the Federación. They can serve in France, they can serve in a private albergue, serve anywhere they want. And some of them do. So we supply a lot of handouts for our training. A couple that are very, very popular, feedback-wise, are we prepare a little recipe book for people who are going to serve and really don't know what to cook. And as you know, as a hospitalero, you can cook the same thing for 15 days. You're the only one that's going to eat it twice or three times. The other thing that we found useful is something called Thanksgiving at the table in a refuge. These are ideas for oración services, poems that can be included in oración services. So many of the people that we train have left organized religion, and so many of the pilgrims have left organized religions. Some want to say the Lord's Prayer, but then they can't remember the whole thing. So we've got it in five different languages here, so that they can find it. We found this has given our hospitaleros a good guide to providing comfort in oración service type of situation to the pilgrims. So I have a handout today. Have a handout today that basically has a summary of what I've said, and on the verso, a bibliography of some 18 books, many books that have been published by Canadians in about the past 10 years about the Camino. So I'll just hand them out as I leave the stage. Thank you very much.